Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some have been a Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm your bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed.
I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at the breast of everything, this wonderful charitable organization, this event right here at the Marriott in Melville, Long Island. And I am here with this lovely brunette. Her name is Roberta.
Yep.
Introduce.
I'm Roberta Perry of Scrubzbody.com, and we've been hosting this event since it started in my home 10 years ago.
Yes,
so
tell me.
I'm excited.
It is a very exciting event. I mean, 10 years.
It was one of those things that my sister Michelle and I decided we wanted to do was give back right away when we started our company. And so we moved all the furniture aside and we started this little event. We raised a couple thousand dollars and we were thrilled. And when Shari of the WTFC was a vendor at our event selling her merchandise, because she is a survivor, so that was 9 years ago, we realized that, you know, pairing up together would be a great idea. So we started this event. We called it the Breast of Everything. And what moved from my house, then to the Hamlet, then to the Holiday Inn, now got so big that we're at the Marriott in Melville for our first year, and we're expecting about 600 people. We're so excited.
600 people.
Yeah.
Now, this is a shopping event.
It's both shopping and casino night, which is amazing, because you get a combination of the guys shopping and the girls playing casino, or the guys doing casino and the girls shopping. We've got about $25,000 worth of donated goods, amazing raffles. 100%, I can't stress that enough, 100% of the event monies, the net proceeds, goes to the WTFC. It's the WTFC.org. Our own fundraising sort of event website is breastofeverything.com. So you can kind of see event pictures and things like that. But 100% of the monies is donated for research, just specific. 100%.
Wow, that's wonderful. Now tell my audience, there must be a special reason why you are so devoted to this cause. Was there someone in your family?
Not in my family, but right when we had started this business was also around the time that a good friend of mine had just gone through surgery. And I realized, I counted up the people I had in my life, and I knew 9 people.
That had breast cancer?
But they were all survivors.
Well, you know, I had breast cancer, too.
I heard that, too. Yeah. So, and you're here, and you're a survivor,
yeah.
And that's the coolest thing.
Well,
so, that's
weird, because we don't know what causes this breast cancer. Is it a genetic thing? Is it environmental?
It could be a combination of both.
And I think it could be a combination of both,
yeah,
as well. I think that my mother, and see, this is the deal with me. My mother had it, my grandmother had it. Did they have it? Is there a gene? I still don't know, because I got tested
there
for the BRCA.
Is, right, exactly. But again, that's the medical aspect of it, I obviously can't go into.
Or
but
is
for
it
me.
Something, or is it something about we lived in an environment that we were eating the same things, we were drinking the same thing, or we were smelling the air or the pesticides that they were spraying
I'll
in the air?
I'll say yes to everything and no to everything, only because of the fact that I think it's a combination that everybody, what I've read, walks around with possibilities and genetic predisposition, environment, I think it's all a factor. But the coolest part is that the diagnosis doesn't mean, you know,
that you're going to die
anymore. And that's the beautiful thing, is that that's why with the WTFC, every dollar going for research is hitting these doctors who are coming up with these, you know, life-changing therapies and life-changing alternatives to what was.
And the key is to be diagnosed
as soon as possible. Give yourself a breast exam at least once a month. Have your regular mammogram. Have a sonogram even. Take care of yourself. It's so important.
I was stage 1 breast cancer.
So you're lucky they caught it so early.
It never spread to any of my lymph nodes, but it's still very scary.
Yeah.
Because you always think there's like something somewhere lurking somewhere that could develop into something else.
Clean living, try your best, positive attitude. You know, we always say, my company Scrubs, when we first started doing this, we said, what better way while you're giving yourself a Scrubs treatment to give yourself a breast exam? You know, it's kind of like dual purpose, you know? And the more you kind of feel comfortable within your own body and how everything feels, don't be afraid if something feels, go check it out.
Absolutely.
So
absolutely.
Early detection is very, very, very key.
Now tell my audience about your company, Scrubs. Explain to my audience about it.
It's called Scrubzbody. It's a natural skincare company. It was something that sort of was born out of my wanting finally to take care of my own skin needs, and products that I was finding weren't satisfying them. And so I kind of played around in the kitchen for a while, and I gave some out as gifts, and my sister loved it, and she called me screaming one day. You know, she wouldn't let me, you know, I was in a business meeting, and it was like, well, I got the perfect name. And so this evolved out of like, okay, let's do something. Okay, great. And we were amazed that 10 years later, we're this thriving business in Bethpage, New York.
That's amazing.
You know, and it's great. So again, so it's scrubzbody.com. We're Scrubzbody across all the social platforms. Our store is at 328 Broadway in Bethpage.
So you're local, though. Have you gone national
yet?
We
are national in that we sell around the country, you know, so you can order from anywhere in the country, and the shipping is a whole whopping $6, you know, so or free over 40. And, you know, we make sure that we take care of everybody. You know, we always say it's sort of, you know, why not treat yourself the best you possibly can? It all goes hand in hand with health. It's you know, healthy on the outside, healthy on the inside. And what we make is a natural, handmade product that makes your skin smile, makes your body feel great, and it's good for you, too. And we have a very small footprint, so we're good for the environment as well.
Now, how did you meet Shari?
Shari, I know from way back when our boys were in elementary school. So we've been friends for years, and I remember when I found out she was diagnosed, I was like, oh, you know, another one of my friends, oh no. And her attitude has been amazing, and it's almost 9 years later that she's...
Wow. 9 years.
Not only a survivor herself, but she is an advocate. She has raised tens of thousands of dollars through WTFC, and she's raised, I want to say, about $250,000 for Komen and the walk in September, so she's pretty
happy. She's truly a remarkable lady. She really is. I want you to tell my audience where we could go to participate, where we could go to contribute, and where we could go to donate. What is the website?
So the website, again, is breastofeverything.com is the event website, and there's a donate button right there. You'll learn more about the event itself. We do this once a year, but the WTFC, Women Together Fighting Cancer, is the WTFC.org. And again, 100% of tonight's net proceeds go directly to WTFC, and 100% of WT goes to research. So,
and what is your website? We want to find out more about your products.
Scrubs with a Z, body.com. So S-C-R-U-B-Z, body.com.
Roberta, you're gorgeous.
Thank you. We're so happy to have you here, Cognac. I really appreciate it.
I'm so happy to be here. And we'll be back in a moment, darlings, with more interviews coming up. Keep watching Pink Champagne Kisses. I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at the Breast of Everything, this wonderful charitable organization right here having this beautiful charity event at the Marriott at Melville. And I am here with this young lady who is a big supporter of this event. Introduce yourself to the camera.
Hi, I am Michelle Tucker, and I am from Scrubs. And I work with my sister, who you just interviewed.
Yes, before, Roberta.
Roberta, as well as Shari. And we do this event on an annual basis in support of breast cancer research. And we love what we do.
I could see that. And your sister was telling me so much about the company.
That's a baby.
Now tell my audience how you got involved. I mean, could you tell my audience what you do? Tell us what you do at the at your company to help Roberta.
Yeah, well, Roberta's the president. I'm the vice president. You know, we're co-owners. And we each have different things that we do, so we don't overlap with one another. But I'm in charge of the store, decorating the store, doing the windows. I do social media, you know, the...
Which is so important today, right?
Instagram, Facebook, things like that. You know, we all try to hone in on what we excel in, and that is kind of what we do with the business. When it comes to dealing with customers, things like that, we all partake. But you know, we each have our own thing, like I said, and it works out well. It's very well balanced.
And I understand that you're doing extremely well. I mean, the company is really thriving.
We are, thank goodness. We started out of my sister's house. You know, she started making it for herself and then gave me some to try. And next thing you know, we started a business. And it's constantly been evolving. It went from her house to our first retail store in Bethpage.
That's wonderful.
It is, and we outgrew that store, so then we moved to another store because we do parties at our store, make your own scrub parties, which is awesome. We do ladies' nights, birthday parties, Girl Scout troops. So we needed a bigger space, and now we're in the heart of town. We love being in Bethpage, and knock on wood, we're doing great.
I'm so happy to hear that. I really am. And here you are tonight at this event, and you're helping raise a lot of money for breast cancer.
A lot of money for breast cancer. This is our 10th anniversary. Roberta and I started the breast cancer event, you know, when we first started our business. And then we joined up with Shari, who, you know, is a good friend. She's a survivor. And now we've been working together. And it's a wonderful thing. And it just keeps growing and growing. You know, we started out of my sister's house. Then we needed, you know, a clubhouse at Shari, you know, the condo complex she lives in, and then we went from there to another hotel, and then we outgrew that hotel, and here we are at the Marriott in Melville. So it's something that just, you know, it keeps going up.
What would you like to see happen for Scrubbies? What's your goal? What would you like to see happen in the next year for the company?
I would like to see it continually grow, like the, you know, the way it has been.
I'd like to see bit more stores around the country.
You know, right, not around the country. You know, we like being a small woman-owned business. We like the retail, actually. We also do wholesale, but we prefer the retail aspect, and we do the parties. Possibly have another location also on the island. Grow our party business because they're so much fun. And just, you know, continue to make great products that customers love, enjoy, they benefit from, and to keep doing good, you know, to keep providing everybody with things that can benefit them health-wise. You know, natural is the way, and we're trying to give that to people for the outside of their bodies. They still have to do natural on the inside to take care of themselves as well. But, you know, we're trying to give them the best thing at an affordable price because everybody deserves to use natural products and let Mother Nature do her thing.
Absolutely, absolutely. I want you to tell my audience where we could go to find out more information. What's the website?
Absolutely. Our website is scrubzbody.com, and you can contact us at www.scrubzbody.com. We've got a retail store in Bethpage, New York, on Broadway, 328 Broadway, and that has the entire product line, which is cool, and we make everything there.
What's the best product? Tell my audience, what's your biggest selling item?
Well, scrub, of course, the scrubs, which is our main product. That's what got us going. That, of course, is the number one seller. I'm a sweet milk and honey fan. That is my most favorite scent. I always say that even though we offer so many scents, if I was on a tropical island stranded and I could only pick one to have forever, sweet milk and honey would be for me.
Okay.
That and our bye-bye bags. Our bye-bye bags, I swear by. It's amazing. It's an under eye cream that does 10 times more than just being an under eye cream.
Do you sell fragrance too, or just, you know, body scrubs and moisturizing?
We do. Well, we have kind of everything, you know, for everybody.
Tell us one more time, what is the website? That's all we really need.
The website is www.scrubzbody, S-C-R-U-B-Z, body, B-O-D-Y, .com, and it has everything you want to know about scrubs, why it's great for you, our entire product line. It tells you about our parties. It tells you about the different fundraising efforts that we make. So, you know, we do breast cancer, obviously. We're doing this event, but we also donate to other wonderful causes as well.
Thank you so much for that wonderful interview.
Thank you. Wow. Thank you for coming and joining us.
And don't
us.
Go away. We'll be back in a moment, darling. Some more interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses. Welcome back, darlings. I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at the Marriott in Melville, and we're celebrating the breast of everything, this wonderful charitable event that is being held tonight. And I'm here with the founder, Shari Goldsmith. What a pleasure to come and be a part of this tonight, Shari.
I appreciate you being here. We've worked really hard. 10 years ago, this event started in my partner's house as a small fundraiser for the Komen organization.
Okay, tell me all about it.
And so after a few years and I got involved, I was diagnosed and I'm a survivor, and so I started my own 501c3, the WTFC, which stands for the What the F Club.
What the F Club.
Because you have to live for today, because you don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. And
Can you tell my audience the story about what happened, how you were diagnosed, and how you found out? Can you tell us the story?
Sure. My mother passed away from breast cancer when I was 20 years old. She was 52 years old. I worried my whole life about whether I would carrying a gene or not. And a number of years later, my aunt, my mother's sister, was then also diagnosed with breast cancer, and that's when I was sure that it was in the family. But my aunt really didn't want to be tested, so I did get tested, and I tested negative.
You tested negative?
I thought I had a free pass, and then one June Monday afternoon in 2007, at about 4 o'clock, I got that dreaded phone call.
And I know the phone call. I had it too.
Picked up the phone, and the radiologist said, "Shari, I'm sorry to tell you, your biopsy came back positive. You have breast cancer."
And what stage breast cancer did you have?
You know, if you don't mind, I prefer not discussing that. But I'm good, and I unfortunately lost my aunt a few years later to ovarian cancer because she didn't get tested until it was too late, and she'd actually tested herself in her 60s thinking there was no need to. She was already in her 60s, but it came back positive, and she did prophylactic oophorectomy, and they found cancer, and she ended up dying of ovarian cancer. So being proactive, and if you have any family history, getting genetic testing is so important. So many people put their heads in the ground and don't want to know and don't want to think about it, and it doesn't matter, but it's life-saving. And for me, I was negative, but you know, I was very diligent because I knew there was a family history. There'll be other genes they'll discover. We'll find out why I had it also, but meantime,
sometimes it's the environment that we live in. Maybe your mother and you did the same things, and that's why you both ate some. I think maybe it was something my mother, because my mother had breast cancer.
Yeah.
My grandmother had cancer.
Genetic testing?
I just had the genetic testing. I had the BRCA testing, but we're still waiting to get the results. Yeah.
I mean, listen. You know, environment sure plays a role in everything, and we don't really know what role it plays in breast cancer. We also know, you know, Long Island has higher rates of breast cancer than...
Why is that?
Well, it could be the environment. It also could be because there's a lot of Ashkenazi Jews who live on Long Island, and we have more breast cancer than you know, others, so...
I'm not Jewish. I'm Italian.
Well, it can happen to anyone. And you know that less than 10% of all breast cancer is hereditary.
You know, the doctor said that to me. He said, "You're Jewish, right?" And I says, "No, darling, I'm Italian." He's a Chinese doctor, Dr. Lee. He said that to me.
He was just, you know, flirting with you.
Yeah, they often do like to flirt. I had very handsome doctors. I have to tell you, my one oncologist, he looked like Omar Sharif. I said, the surgeon, the doctor that actually did the surgery.
Yeah.
people, he's like a scientist. People go to him to find out how to do surgery on breast cancer
Where's
patients. He's at South Nassau Community Hospital. And he's an amazing doctor.
Yeah.
And with me, with my situation, I was always flat-chested. I never had breasts. I was so flat. So I said to the doctor, if I had breast cancer, if I, you know, I had stage one breast cancer, I said, you know what, take them both off. And I mean, I don't have anything anyway, so what the hell, just take them off and give me new ones, and bigger ones too.
So you're happy with what you have now?
I got nice breasts, I'm covering them today. They're beautiful breasts and they look terrific. I have better breasts now than I did when I was 16 years old.
And you know what, you'll be long gone and they'll still be standing at attention.
Isn't that great? So I tell people, don't fear that, don't fear having the surgery. The fear is not getting the biopsy. The fear is not getting the mammogram. That's the fear. Like you said, it all can be prevented. You could, once they find this out, you know, this, you're on your way to becoming cured.
You have to be proactive. You know, knowledge is power. Power can save your life. You know, to be afraid, I understand it's scary and people don't want to know, but you have, when you know, you have choices. You can make choices. You can save your life.
And you did, and so did I. And I want you to tell my audience now with this organization, what are your goals for this upcoming year?
Well, do you mind if I tell you how it came about?
Yes, tell
okay,
my
great.
Audience.
Like,
we want to hear the whole story.
I'd like to tell you. So I was I had my double mastectomy, and I was about to go through treatment, and my young 16-year-old son needed sneakers. So it wasn't easy. I was really, you know, in a tough spot at that time. But we went to the sneaker store, and while I was sitting there waiting for him, I saw this crazy colored pair of sneakers on the wall, and I looked at them, and I said, you're too old for that. Don't even think about it. And then I said, oh, let me just try them on. But so I put them on and I bought them and I walked outside of that store with my sneakers and I said to myself, for the rest of my life, this is how I'm going to live. WTF. Not just monetary things, but spending more time with my family, leaving the dishes in the sink, rereading a book, whatever it is, that in 1 second your life can change so drastically. One phone call, it all changes, and it all becomes so much more precious than you ever knew before. And so over the next few months of treatment, I would get calls from friends saying, you know, I did this today, what the F today? And I got a call from my aunt, and she said, so, president of the What the F Club, I did new bedding today. And I said, you know, maybe I could do something with this. I wanted a cure. I was going through so much with the treatment. I wanted a cure. So I created logos, and we hired an attorney. We set up the 501c3, and a year later, we launched the WTFC organization, and we've raised money through small events, Zumba-thons. I did a lot of craft fairs where I sold my WTFC logo merchandise, and over the years, we've built it, and now we do the Breast of Everything as our major fundraiser, and each year, it's been growing and growing, and we're hoping tonight's going to be our biggest one. Last year, we raised $34,000.
Oh, my God, that's amazing. So, that's wonderful. That's truly, truly wonderful.
And we've made contributions to 16 research facilities through the United States, 22.
What about the Don Monty Research Foundation? I just went to the Pink Tie Gala.
The Pink Tie. We donated to the Feinstein Institute. They were doing a breast cancer, ovarian cancer study bank many years ago. Actually, the WTFC is etched in the Women's Cats Pavilions in both for our donations. And we've donated to Sloan Kettering and Johns Hopkins and City of Hope. And I mean, the list goes on. Please look at the website at WTFC.org.
I will definitely look.
You know.
So what would you like to see this year surpass? What would you like to, well, how much money would you like to raise this year?
Well, you know what? I would love to be able to at least raise what we raised last year, and over and above that, I'd be thrilled. But I like to keep my numbers low because I don't want to not be able to make my goal.
And thank you, Shari,
I
so
really,
much.
I really appreciate you coming
in. Mwah. One more time, the website.
www.thewtfc.org. What the F. Have a great night, everybody.
And we'll be back in a moment, darlings. Keep watching. More interviews coming up. Pink champagne kisses.
Fabulously dressed to impress. One of a kind girl. This has been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.